The basic idea of mobile banking is that a person moves some cash to a mobile wallet, that is, to electronic money, sometimes referred to as e-money. This can be done through an agent associated with a telecommunications company, or it can be done by a banker that may be associated with the mobile money provider, which could be the bank itself. The money then resides in the mobile wallet and can be used to pay other people, pay bills, pay for loans, etc. Technically, a mobile wallet need not be associated with a phone, but in most countries, it is. Suppose person A wants to move money to person B. Person B also needs a mobile wallet or a bank account if the mobile banking firm allows payments directly into bank accounts. The application will ask who the money is going to. Sometimes just the name and their phone number is enough, and then how much to send. Press a button and poof, the money goes to their account. Sometimes it floats in an intermediate account until person B accepts it. Or perhaps the mobile banking firm needs to check that person A really has the money in their wallet to begin with, and that person B is a legitimate recipient. After the transfer, person B can then find an agent or bank to move the e-money back into cash, or person B can just hold it in their mobile wallet for future transactions of their own. Variations on this basic transaction mainly deal with the elements in between person A and person B once they have an e-money account of some type. The regulatory structure and the types of operators of mobile banking systems determine how these elements are constructed and what risks may be associated with them.